When you look at something for the first time, the deeper meaning is often invisible to you. A beginner may see chaotic marks and dots, but then suddenly an aha moment arrives. In our optical illusion here, we can see a Dalmatian. Such crucial turning points, where we start to see things differently, can be found in each and every scientific field of study. They often concern difficult concepts or complicated theories which may sound illogical and even contradictory to the students at first. In science education, these are sometimes called threshold concepts. Threshold concepts are particularly interesting, as they alter your perception of scientific content and may even change your worldview. After this flash of insight, it is hard to revert back to the previous state. There is basically no way back to your original level of understanding. Once you understand a threshold concept, you may even find it hard to believe that you ever saw the world differently. Experts say that this may be a reason why it's often challenging for them to empathize with students. They find it difficult to retrace their steps back to the days when they did not yet have the understanding of threshold concepts. However, it is highly beneficial for students when you, as a teacher, identify such threshold concepts or bottlenecks in learning. Let's have a deeper look at threshold concepts and why they make learning new things extremely troublesome. Threshold concepts are key to a student's deeper understanding of a specific topic. Without this understanding, the student won't progress in their scientific learning or achieve mastery. A threshold concept can be considered as akin to a portal, opening up a new and previously inaccessible way of thinking about something. It represents a transformed way of understanding or interpreting or viewing something without which the learner cannot progress.
So I usually start by explaining threshold concepts as a really valuable framework that people can use and hold lightly to start thinking about their students' learning. So I often position it as it's a really nice way to move from thinking about what do I teach to what do I want my students to learn.
We're particularly interested in why some students, often quite gifted students, very able students, still get stuck with certain aspects of their learning. And it's trying to help both the students and their professors to kind of help them get out of that stuck space.
Let's try to understand a bit more about such bottlenecks and what role they play in the learning process. Threshold concepts are transformative. These new concepts may contrast strongly with previous ways of thinking, which can create a disorienting dilemma for students. This forces them to think critically about their underlying assumptions and beliefs about the world. In such instances, a transformed perspective is likely to involve an affective component, a shift in values, feeling, or attitude. Second, understanding a threshold concept is irreversible, in that the change of perspective occasioned by acquisition of a threshold concept is unlikely to be forgotten, or will be unlearned only by considerable effort. Take, for example, the concept of fractal geometry from Benoit Mandelbrot. You will notice that in nature, we're surrounded by patterns, appearing and reappearing in repeating patterns with complexity. First, you might have doubts about this concept, but once you have trained your perception, recognition of fractal geometry is irreversible. Threshold concepts are also integrative because they expose the interrelatedness of different phenomena. They show previously hidden connections between things, and add knowledge to the bigger picture. It's basically putting puzzle pieces together. A novice might only see the green leaves of the plant, whereas an expert recognizes the repeating patterns of fractal geometry in the structures of each teeny tiny part of the leaf. Such interrelated knowledge allows you to make new connections that were hidden before. A threshold concept is often intrinsic to a scientific discipline. It's seen as an ultimate truth, as unquestionable. But these concepts also differ between disciplines. As Ray Land explains, uncertainty is a concept many disciplines come up with as a threshold, but uncertainty is very different in climate studies from what it is in law or surgery, and the way it is connected to other concepts is bounded differently in different disciplines. Finally, threshold concepts can be troublesome. Novel ideas can feel foreign, even counterintuitive. The new concepts may appear to contradict older understandings at first, and students have to deal with the cognitive dissonance caused in order to merge the concepts. Deep reflection and the chance of experiencing the new concept in multiple ways will help the student to integrate new knowledge. Learning new and highly complex information can be challenging for students, and your role as a teacher is crucial for supporting their individual progress in their scientific learning. One of the advantages you, as a young teacher, have is that you're closer to the student's state of development. It's easier for you to relate to their pre-threshold concept level of understanding. Understanding where students are on their learning journey is crucial. Teachers should expect threshold concepts to be hard to learn, and therefore build in sufficient time for this to take place. You should plan to confront students' previous understanding by presenting vivid, perhaps even multi-sensory examples that illustrate the threshold concept in practice. Some students may even argue with the new knowledge. This is natural, and it's crucial to create a conducive atmosphere so students can grapple with the new knowledge openly. It may sound cliched, but there really are no stupid questions, if you think of every question as a valuable teachable moment. As the teacher, you're responsible for creating an open space that is conducive for students to critically question commonly held views. This will increase the trust between the students and yourself, and trust is the foundation upon which all positive learning experiences take place.